My name's Tom, this is The Enthusiasm Project, and today I'm gonna show you how to create quick and easy titles and graphics for your videos using the iPad Pro, Apple Pencil, and Procreate. So by the end of this video, you're going to be able to use Procreate to design your very own unique custom titles and graphics. Now I made another video about creating animated titles with Procreate that I'll link to right here. That's a slightly different process. It's very quick and easy, but that's to make titles that are animated. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to make not animated titles and graphics, kind of like this one right here, which was super quick, super easy. I throw it at the beginning of all of my videos, and then I actually just use a really quick transition to make it look like it comes in and goes out, but it's just a really simple iris transition. I first started using Procreate to create my titles about 8 months ago, and since then, I haven't used a single typed out title on any of the videos on my channel. Not that there's anything wrong with that. I just like the customized look you can get with Procreate. This isn't like a sponsored video or anything. I just think it's a really great, really powerful app, and it costs something like $5. So it's super worth the price that you pay for it. And adding in the handwritten titles, hand designed titles, really gives your videos a sense of personality and uniqueness that it's kind of hard to achieve if you're just using the same things that everyone else is using. So let's jump right into Procreate on the iPad, and I'll show you how to create your own custom titles. And the first thing that you'll notice, at least on my iPad, is that my Procreate is basically just titles. There's things for presentations, there are things for videos. It's pretty much one of the only things I actually use Procreate for, and I absolutely love it for that. So to design these titles, I'm gonna create a new document. For me, the size isn't an issue because I'm using Final Cut Pro. If you're using Final Cut or Premiere, you can freely position and transform objects. So I just select screen size, and that's the canvas size that I'll work with. Now, when it comes to brushes, I usually use the monoline brush, which is in the calligraphy collection. And the reason for that is because as you're drawing and outlining your letters, the other brushes kind of keep your really rough edges. So like, for example, right here, you can really see that there's some roughness happening there. In order to avoid that, I use the monoline brush because it just kind of automatically corrects and makes it very easy to do very smooth, very simple lines. And again, this tutorial specifically is all about speed and efficiency. So there are ways that you can create your layers and you can play with them and you can add all kinds of stuff and make them very detailed. This is for a scenario where you're making a video and you realize, oh my gosh, I need to put a title here or a little drawing or something really, really quickly, and I need to go from designing it to having it in Final Cut Pro in like 1 or 2 minutes, the same amount of time it would take to do it with the built-in titler. So in order to do that, I usually start with a white brush. I make the background layer transparent, then I just outline the shapes of my letters, and I've made a few drawing tutorials. If you've watched any of those, the biggest piece of advice I give is when you're trying to do lettering, do not write the letters, but draw the shapes of the letters. It's a totally different way of doing things, and it really helps you to understand the shape and design of your letters. And so there we go, we've got this really simple title. In order to get it into Final Cut, all we need to do is share it as a PNG. A PNG file will protect the transparent background, and then I should just send it to my MacBook Pro. It'll pop up on my MacBook, and then I can just throw it into Final Cut. Now I'll maximize Final Cut Pro, and here's the title. Now, just like anything else, you can adjust the timing of the title. You can click on transform to adjust the position of the title. And then, as much as I kind of hate to admit that I do this, a lot of times when I do these titles, especially since I use white, I actually do add a drop shadow. I've had an aversion to drop shadows ever since I was in high school and I first learned Photoshop, and I went drop shadow crazy. Once I realized the error of my ways, I stopped using them as much, but they really do come in handy for pulling your text out from the background. Now I've got my title that'll pop up when I want it to in the video. If I wanted to add some more animations, I could keyframe this. I could even go into transitions and add like a cross dissolve to make it fade in or fade out whenever I want it to. If I ever add transitions to my titles, I usually make them as quick as possible, so that way they're not distracting, but it really gives it an extra layer of texture. And that's pretty much it. The same basic process would work the same in Adobe Premiere, Final Cut Pro, basically any editor. You can get as advanced as you want. You can change colors, you can change positions, and it's a really quick way to have titles rather than just going into your titler, grabbing a title, and creating something that doesn't look nearly as unique. And obviously, there's nothing wrong with built-in titlers. You can do fantastic work with them. But this is just a really cool thing, especially for the kinds of videos I make, maybe the kinds of videos you make, that really adds an awesome personal touch.
So that's pretty much it. It's a very simple, very easy process. That's the whole point, is that by doing this method, it's not gonna take you any more time than it normally would to set up titles in your editor. The steps I laid out would be the same whether you're using Final Cut Pro or Premiere or pretty much any other editing software. If you're using something that's a little bit more limited, something like iMovie where you can't freely position objects around the frame, then it would be important to make sure that your files are the size of your screen, 1920 by 1080 or whatever resolution you're filming in. So that way, as soon as you put it into your editor, everything is automatically positioned where you need it. But if you're using one of the more advanced editors like Final Cut or Premiere, then you should be able to freely position your graphics wherever you want them, and that really cuts down on time and increases your flexibility. And I feel like it's important to mention that while Procreate is a really affordable app at like $5 or whatever, I know that the iPad Pro and the Apple Pencil are not inexpensive things. You don't have to have these tools to do this method. You can do this without the Apple Pencil. You can use a regular stylus. You can use your finger. You don't need an iPad Pro. You can use your phone. Anything that runs Procreate, you can do this method on. This is just what I use because it's become very, very easy. For me personally, the Apple Pencil on the iPad Pro, especially with an anti-glare screen protector on it, is the closest digital thing I've found to paper yet. And that feels so good to draw on and to use. So it's my favorite combination. So that's it. It's really simple, really easy. I very much hope it was helpful. Feel free to ask any questions in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed, please make sure to do so. So that way you get new videos, live streams, tutorials every single week. And I will see you guys next time.